My name is Sabine. I'm from Germany. I'm totally happy to meet you. And my question is, the reading of the Vedas deepens more and more, especially due the gift of the daily satsang in this corona time. The prayer for Simanda Swami touches me deeply every day. But there's one sentence she's not able to understand. Please shower me with your grace so that I meet a living representative of you like a Gnani Purush or a Sat Purush. But we already met him in Gnanvidhi and got his grace. Why do we ask for this here? I think it stays, it's stable, it's a connection with will br break never.
Yeah, definitely. But still, we are asking, and suppose this is not our last birth. So next life we may take birth in one or two birth in this earth. Then our intention, somebody, Jnani Purush or Sat Purush, should we meet to them person, and again my knowledge of self remain enlightened, and after finishing all karma of this world, then I will take new birth in near Lord Simandar Swami and ultimate salvation. So with the, if possible, one or two life we have to come back in this earth, then our intention, we want some living representative like Dada Bhagwan. Somebody, we should meet that person, enlightened person, and our knowledge of self remain enlightened with the grace of that person. So our intention within one or two life, we should, when we, if we come back, so we want to remain in touch with Jnani Purush or Sat Purush.
But
Understood?
is it possible to have a life after this and not
Yeah.
get in contact with him? Is it possible?
Yes, suppose you are coming from Germany. So you have to go to, say, Dubai, then next stop is Delhi, then to Bombay, then Ahmedabad. So we have to take one or two stopover, but towards Ahmedabad only. So like one or two stopover towards path of salvation of Lord Simandar Swami Mahavidya Kshetra. So before that, one or two life miss, we have to come back in this world. So in that world, we want some Jnani Purush. So we want to stay around Jnani Purush only. So our intention, we are praying. Understood?
Little bit was a fear. Maybe I miss him or something like this, but I now understood.
Okay. Jai
Yes, that's
Sachidana.
another. Thank you.
Jai Sachidana Guruji.
Jai Sachidana.
My name is Suvad from Germany. Can you please explain how Akram Vignan is a science?
Yes. This physical science is a science of element: gold, silver, sodium, potassium, chlorine. And this is eternal element. This is science, spiritual science of eternal element. Suppose bad, dirty water is there. So from dirty water, we are making clean water, drinking water. So that is called religion. From bad to good, we are coming. And in bad water, if there is a, we are doing scientific experiment, so automatically oxygen will separate and hydrogen will get separate. So element remain pure in bad water also. And when we remove element, it is called science. In water, we are separating hydrogen, oxygen, is a physical science. In this body, I am husband, I am father, I am son, I am engineer, I am doctor. In all this relativity, somebody is an angry person, somebody is a proud person, greedy person. Still, inside, pure soul is always pure. And that purity of pure soul, that pure soul can be realized by spiritual science. All these bad habits or good habits, but pure soul is totally separate from all discharge karma or all this relative karma or this mind, speech and body action. So soul, and we want to experience that soul, and that soul can be experienced by spiritual science. This is called eternal element, science of eternal element. You understood?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Jai Satchidanand.
Yes. Jai Satchidanand. Jai Satchidanand Buddhashri. Hayas namaskars. In Aptavani 14, there is a statement where Dadashri tells that it is essential being free and stay not attached in the present moment, so that the attention is flowing free. And I noticed since the last question, which was about being and acting in alignment with Prajna, this non-attachment is free-flowing of attention is more experienced. It is not always successful, but more and more, there is more awareness. So could you give me, please, more keys how to be and act more in alignment with Prajna and to be attached, not attached, stay free and stay free in the here and now, the now moment and in the present moment, so that each moment will be a free, liberated moment. That's the first question.
Yeah.
The second also now?
Yeah, it will continue with that. But a very important part, we are practicing 5 agnas. We are keeping separation. We are saying flawlessly, everybody. Still, where we miss that 5 agna, that we have to find out. And when we reset that awareness, automatically our awareness will be more and more, and that continuity will be there. So when we find out where I miss 5 agna, where I have seen some fault of others, negativity of others, find out. See, miss pure soul, seeing pure soul inside. This is file. This is whatever happened is a scientific circumstance. Where I miss 5 agna, find out. And reset again and again. And every day we have to do where I miss 5 agna, and again reset that anger, pride, deceit, greed, discharge atom of this kashaya that will disturb awareness of keeping 5 agnas. So when we reset our 5 agna, we will able to dissolve anger or pride or deceit or greed, attachment, abhorrence, we will dissolve. So every day we have to keep this awareness. I want to remain continuously in every phases. I want to remain in 5 agnas. And that will help you, that separation and inside bliss all the time. And that will increase your awareness as well as Prajna Shakti. Completely awakened stage of Prajna Shakti. Understood?
Yes. And how do I reset the awareness? Is that setting the 5 agnas or is it a different way?
No, 5 agna. And
to,
watch.
To reset the awareness.
Yes, 5 agna, practice 5 agna and check where Claudia doing mistake or what thoughts are of Claudia coming, speech of Claudia, action of Claudia, intellect of Claudia, it interference here and there. So we will watch file 1 completely. Watch file 1, that is biggest awareness, biggest separation. So what Claudia is doing, you just observe. Understood?
Okay.
Jai Satchidanand.
Jai Satchidanand, Catherine Essa from France.
Yes.
My question is, my file 1 can experience the 5 agnas sensually with its senses. I can experience pure soul, the relative I, the working of the circumstances, equanimity in myself and satsang. I'm doing all the efforts with all something I can really experience. But my file one cannot experience that the soul is immortal, or rebirth, or the existence of the Tantra Lord. So for my file one, all these things remain opinions. But without the conviction of immortality, for instance, there is always fear of dying, and there is always attachment to the relative life. So my file one would nevertheless like to become free of attachment, but is really blocked. Do you have a clue?
Yeah, you have to understand, ego, he has oneness with body. So ego feels, I will die. So he has fear of dying, not pure soul. As a pure soul, you are observer of ego, intellect, Katrine. So Katrine, ego has a feeling of dying. And so when you see these are the temporary things, so when you see all this relative is temporary, automatically you are coming in the permanency, stage of permanency. So we have to understand all this relative is temporary. Who will say this is temporary? Permanent thing can say this is temporary. Temporary thing cannot say this is temporary. So you are permanent and Katrine is temporary. So ego of Katrine feels the experience that I will die, what will happen? He wants some relative things, physical things, attachment for relative things. But he has, because it is, now we understood Katrine has attachment for relative things. I am pure soul. Keep yourself as a pure soul. Soul is immortal. I am not going to die. No birth, no death of pure soul. But in ignorance stage, we believe that I am Katrine, I am so and so. So now from that egoism, we are separated. But egoism is there. So he feel that I am going to die. So we will say, oh, this body is going to die. You are not going to die. You come in a stage of pure soul. So you are also feeling that I am immortal. Body is going to die because body is a physical state. It will take birth as well as one day it will die. But egoism, just believing that I am going to die. Because I am this body, but if egoism understood, I am not this body, I am pure soul, then fear of dying will go away. Because he feels I am body, that's why he has fear. He understood, I am not this body, I am pure soul. Then soul is not going to die. So all the time we have to keep awareness, this relative things is governed by scientific circumstantial evidence. I am not this relative thing. I am knower and seer of relative things. So you are as a pure soul, knower and seer of relative things. And pure soul is immortal, not going to die, not taking birth. So,
understand? My file one inside is really upset. Because what my file one says then is that, yeah, you are the knower and the seer, but I am the eyes. So when my eyes close because I'm dying, you can't see anything anymore, no way, and see it. So no. There's really dispute inside.
No, but there are three parts. One physical body, one is egoism, and third is a pure soul. So egoism is due to ignorance. So that egoism has, I am this body. That's why he feels that body will die. So he feels, I'm going to die. But here, egoism just believing that I am going to die. But he is not really dying. Only physical body gets dying. So he taking new birth. Due to ignorance, he taking again and again birth and death, new and. If you understand that, oh, I am not this body, I am pure soul, then he is not going to die. Physical body is going to die. And if this physical body dies, still we will take new birth, and we are knower and seer all the time. So that is permanent stage. But by understanding, this is wrong belief. I with wrong belief is egoism. So egoism is wrong belief. I am this body, I am this speech, I am this doing, I am this Katrina. So this is wrong belief. Now we got oh, I am not this Katrina, I am pure soul. So by this right belief, you can feel, you can experience permanency. Relative things are temporary and real things are permanent. So by real thing, we can say, I am immortal. And egoism say, I will die. But you are believing that this is my body, I am this body. That's why you feel I am going to die. But you are not this body. You are pure soul, then you are not going to die. Understand?
I think I'll ask for lots of energy and good circumstances that I can come.
Slowly practice 5 Agna and keep separation with Katrin. File 1 is separate, I am pure soul. In Charanvidhi, all sentences given for soul. What are the virtues? What are the qualities of the pure soul? I am infinite knowledge. I am full of infinite wisdom. So we will do that Charanvidhi and understand, oh, this my part is permanent and relative part is temporary.
Jai Sachidananda.
Jai Sachidananda.
Jai Sachidananda Puchashri.
Jai Sachidananda.
Sorry, I have another COVID vaccine question. This is really strange being in this space with you to ask a question in that. But in Germany, many people, especially in my surrounding of alternative doctors and healing practitioners, they warn of the vaccine side effects and they say it influences the DNA and cuts your access to your soul. I would love to hear from you about that. And in hearing that, the thought came up, especially as a Mahatma, that this is maybe a help for separation of the relative and the real of the rest of the world.
Actually, as per the theory, vaccine is helping when the virus attack in our body. So without vaccine, when they attack, then our immunity or say all antibodies, they don't know, so they will cannot fight properly. Once vaccine is given, antibodies get prepared, they are ready for whenever virus attack may come of corona, they are ready. So this is really science. They will be ready when any attack of virus come, they will be prepared themselves and they will fight with that virus. That's why vaccine is helpful. As per the theory, they are explaining like this. And very simple, nothing is wrong. I have also taken vaccine and they say our body is remain prepared. If any attack of virus of corona may come, the body will remain, antibodies will be ready to fight with that virus.
But it's only for the fight or does it help not to get it?
No, fight, because the virus attack, they have to fight and they have to remove all the virus and make their body cure. Understood?
I did. Jai Sachidananda, thank you very much.
Now, we'll talk about Samayik. We'll do Samayik for 3rd Agna. In this world, whatever happens is a result of scientific circumstantial evidence only. Human cannot do individually any work. Without help of time, space, evidence, man cannot do anything. Any good work, any bad work. Anything happen negative or positive, everything requires so many evidence. No doubt in past life he has some intention, I want to do such work. So nature will make him as an instrument. But he is not doer of anything. Without help of time, space, evidence, he cannot able to do positive work also. And in this world, so many negative works are happening. We should not blame on any individual person. He has spoiled this, he has done very bad work, very negative work. Nobody is individually doer. It's one of the evidence. And and ultimately fault is of the sufferer. Who is suffering is ultimately his fault, and these negative things happen. So we don't want to blame anybody, but we want to see how the evidence works. And everything happens with the help of circumstantial evidence only. So we have to understand independently, not a single work can be happened by any person independently. Whatever happened is a result of scientific circumstantial evidence. We'll check anything happen. These are the evidence that gives results so and so. That result becomes evidence for something, and that gives another result. That result and some evidence will accumulate, and that again gives some new result. So it depends upon scientific circumstantial evidence again and again, again and again. So world is a result only. By five senses we are experiencing is nothing but result of some evidence. Something happened. Why this tornado came? Due to heat and low pressure and so and so. And it touches to so and so city. Why this is happened? It is also scientific circumstance. Nobody is doer, nobody is creator. So to whom we will blame? Some good work, people say, I have done this work. Some bad work, he has spoiled my work. So we are blaming on others when it is becomes some bad work. And good work, so we are taking on our head, I am doer. But really, in both way, nobody is individual doer, only scientific circumstantial evidence. And now we understood, I am pure soul, I am no renseer in relative, whatever happened, scientific circumstantial evidence. And who is the knower? Pure soul. He is knower only. And due to ignorance, ego generated, that ego will say, I have done so and so, he is doing wrong, I am doing right, I am always right, he is always wrong. So all this wrong understanding. And due to that wrong understanding, they are going to bound new karma. But now we understood, I am pure soul, knower and seer. And whatever happen by five senses, we are whatever we are experiencing, all these relative things, and it is happened by scientific circumstantial evidence. And nobody is individual doer. We should not blame on anybody. So we don't want to see fault of anybody. Whatever happen, we'll accept is justice. Nobody is responsible. And if you find out, in past life, in ignorant stage, we are responsible, whatever we are getting suffering. But now, the instrument or time or space or evidence, they are comes together and gives result. But individually, we cannot say, due to this time, due to this person, due to this evidence, this happened. Nobody is individual responsible for that. So now, today we will do samayik. Whatever happened, good or bad, we will see how the evidence comes and this is happening. Again, due to, say, from birth we will see, so ignorant stage, father or mother, they will give name, you are Deepak, I am believing. Now after Jnani, Dada Bhagwan I got, he says, you are pure soul. So due to this evidence, we are getting ignorance. Due to this evidence, we are getting knowledge of self. So always evidence are helping for development also, for understanding also, negativity also, positivity. But now we understood, these are the evidence, and I am knower and seer, I am pure soul. And due to this evidence, things anger happen. Due to this evidence, negativity happen. Due to this evidence, positivity happen. So we are knower and seer, and how the evidence works, we will see. And for individual evidence or individual person, we will not blame. Nobody is responsible. We will see by this knowledge, this understanding, this third agna, we can see flawlessly worldly people. So today we will do samayik for that, how the scientific circumstantial evidence works, and nobody, individual person, is doer for anything, good or bad. We'll do vidhi.
Please repeat with me. O Sri Simandar Swami.
O Sri Simandar Swami.
O Dada Bhagwan.
O Dada Bhagwan.
Please give me strength.
Please give me strength.
To see.
To see.
How.
How.
The scientific circumstantial evidences.
The scientific circumstantial evidences.
Made things happen.
Made things happen.
In my life.
In my life.
And come out of the ignorance.
And come out of the ignorance.
Of blaming somebody.
Of blaming somebody.
I surrender.
I surrender.
My mind.
My mind.
Body.
Body.
Speech.
Speech.
And all karmas.
And all karmas.
Into the lotus feet of.
Into the lotus feet of.
Simandar Swami.
Simandar Swami.
And Dada Bhagwan.
And Dada Bhagwan.
I am pure soul. 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 I am pure soul.
Jai Sachidanand. Jai Sachidanand to all Mahatmas. Jai Sachidanand. All Westerners, Jai Sachidanand to everybody.